Rehires. This is new at 10. The woman convicted of the drunken driving deaths of two doctors has now rehired the attorney she claimed withheld information in her defense.
It is an abrupt change for the legal defense of Karen Irby. The wife of wealthy philanthropist Stuart Irby has reacquired the very attorney she accused of covering up her chances of beating the drunk driving case, all to protect her husband.
No fanfare, just a notice filed with the court by Karen Irby terminating attorney William Bell and authorizing Joe Holloman to represent her again.
There'll be some additional arguments that we expect to present at the hearing.
That's what Bell said when he took over soon after Karen Irby started serving 18 years for killing doctors Daniel Pogue and Lisa Dedusis in a drunk driving wreck in 2009. But Bell told me over the phone he couldn't comment on his firing because he hadn't seen the document yet. He had launched a furious flurry of legal motions. One attacked the judge who sentenced Karen Irby as being biased because of a poem Tommy Green read in court as if it were written by the victims.
We are both in the best shape we'll ever be today.
We obtained the exclusive surveillance video that showed Karen and Stuart Irby hours and minutes before their deadly wreck. Karen Irby gave depositions in the civil suit filed against the couple, saying her husband was beating her soon after leaving the Jackson Country Club, and that's what caused the Mercedes to wreck with the doctor's truck. She also claimed ineffective counsel because she told Joe Holloman in August and October of 2009 about the blows that caused the wreck. But she says Holloman told her it couldn't be used as a defense and, quote, I don't want to hear anything else about that.
I know that she hopes today's proceedings helps bring further closure for the families.
Stuart Irby paid Joe Holloman more than $500,000 for legal defense in what was argued as a conflict of interest. But she contacted me saying, Joe Holloman, my old attorney, and I are working through stuff. Irby is out of maximum security at Rankin Correctional, sleeping on a top bunk in a barracks-type environment with 108 other inmates.
I made repeated calls to Joe Holloman today, but he did not return them. One of Karen Irby's reasons for wanting to withdraw her guilty plea was that Joe Holloman provided ineffective counsel, but now he's her attorney again. But according to court records today, those motions haven't been filed yet to withdraw it. The state Supreme Court has yet to rule on a motion that she receive a new judge and a new sentencing date.